What's up, you guys? It's me, Kiki Solano, welcoming you to BYUSN Right Now. Today on the show, we're partying like it's 2012 because we continue to see new program records and we continue to see our Cougarettes win. We're also going to continue with this 2012 theme. You'll see why. Let's go. Happy Monday, everyone. Let me take you through this weekend, starting with BYU men's volleyball. Our guys started the weekend off strong, sweeping UCLA on Friday on the road. And then we lost to UCLA on Saturday.
Come again?
And then we lost to UCLA on Saturday. Huh? And then we lost to UCLA on Saturday.
What?
And then we lost to UCLA on Saturday in four sets. We're now 17-3 on the season, and we dropped to number 3 in the rankings. There, I said it. But enough of that. Let's go back to Friday, because not only was that their win of the weekend, but on Friday they also clinched the MPSF Regular Season title, which also means they will be the one seed going into the MPSF tournament, which will be hosted here at BYU. So yeah, let's focus on that. As for number 16, BYU women's soccer, the girls defeated number 25, Pepperdine, 2-1. It was a good weekend for them. Not to mention, this dub gets our girls their first victory in Malibu since 2012. That's 9 years ago. That's been a long time, especially if you consider how young our Cougs were in 2012. Actually, let me show you what that looks like. They've come a long way since then. But let's bring it back to today. More specifically, this weekend. Our Batcats lost their series to Portland 2-1 at home. The Pilots won on Saturday 7-6 after an RBI up the middle in the top of the ninth. But hey, remember when we won 1-0 on Friday?
2-1. Wilk swinging to left field and off the wall. BYU's gonna walk it off. The Cougars win.
Yeah, good times. A team that's been having plenty of good times is BYU softball. The girls swept St. Mary's in their 3-game series on the road. This puts our Cougs on a 9-game win streak, which is pretty big, but it's not as big as the milestones that two of our girls hit this weekend. Autumn Moffitt-Course surpassed 300 career strikeouts in the second game and finished the game with 306. Riley Jensen scored her 200th career run in the first game against the Gales. The senior outfielder is now second all-time at BYU in career runs scored, and she's third nationally among all active D1 softball players. And we have more Cougs showing up in the record books, this time from BYU track and field. This weekend, Michael Bluth set a new program record in the 400 meter, clocking a 45.68. That breaks the previous record set 22 years ago. Should we keep with the theme and show a picture of me 22 years ago? Whoa, actually, let's not. Big congrats to him, and big congrats to our other two athletes who cracked BYU's all-time top 10 records this weekend as well. Finally, let's get to our national hip-hop champs. That is right, the BYU Cougarettes have defended their title, claiming the national hip-hop championship again. This is the program's 20th victory. We always expect amazing things from the Cougarettes, and well, they always deliver. I love this for them, I gotta say. Way to go, ladies. I also want to personally thank them because I believe they may be the ones who inspired the rest of our Cougs to keep on dancing. I mean, how could you not be inspired to dance? Thanks for hanging out with me on BYUSN Right Now. Go give us a follow. I'll see you guys next time. Peace out. Bring back the music.